In this lecture, Sven is going to talk about Jidoka and Poka Yoke.
Hi everybody and welcome to this video lecture about Jidoka, in which we will be learning about defects, how to deal with them and how to prevent them. As you can imagine, defects can occur in any kind of process. If you are familiar with the 4M framework, man, machine, material and method, you can probably think of various sources of defects. To list some examples, humans can forget how to assemble things, machines can overheat, inappropriate material can be delivered by a supplier, and inadequate training can lead to your employees making mistakes. Now, is there a specific way of managing defects? Yes, actually there is one. Sakichi Toyoda, one of the greatest Japanese inventors, had a very good proposition which was later refined by his successors at Toyota. And the approach is Jidoka. Now, what is Jidoka? Some of you might have heard of Jidoka already, as it is a central element of the Toyota production system, next to just-in-time production. The Lean Enterprise Institute defines it as the stop and notification of abnormalities and separation of man's work and machine's work. Let's have a closer look. Jidoka can be translated as automation. You might wonder what that means. Let's look at the Japanese expression. On the left-hand side, you see a Japanese expression which means automation. This is almost how you spell Jidoka in Japanese. The only difference are two red strokes which represent the human and are added to automation. So basically, Jidoka means automation with a human touch, or simply automation. Taichi Ono, another important figure in the development of the Toyota production system, wrote, "The Toyota production system utilizes automation or automation with a human touch, rather than automation. Automation means transferring human intelligence to a machine." Let me illustrate this with an example. In 1925, Sakichi Toyoda invented a machine which could detect errors by itself and free up precious time of the worker. We are talking about the Toyota Model G automatic loom, which had a series of pins on its backside. For each thread, there was one pin that would fall and trigger a lever to stop the machine if a thread broke. This way, one operator could easily supervise up to 50 looms. Human intelligence, in the form of being able to detect a defect and automatically stop the machine, was built into the machine, and that is what characterizes the Jidoka principle. However, this is only half of the story. Jidoka actually consists of 4 steps, out of which 2 have been covered so far: the discovery of abnormalities and stopping the process. There are, however, 2 further steps, which are fixing the problem and investigating and solving the root cause. Following these steps is important for various reasons. First, if we do not stop the process, we keep adding value to a defective product, which might have to be thrown away in the end. Second, the more values added after the defect has occurred, the more work may be needed to remove the defect again. Third, the later the problem is fixed, the more defects may be reproduced. And finally, fourth, the more time has passed since the defect, the more difficult it can be to find the root cause. Let me illustrate the importance of Jidoka with another example. What you can see here are 4 Russian dolls, called matryoshkas. Their assembly process is fairly simple. You open one of them and put the smaller one inside, and repeat that until there is only one doll left, which can be packaged and then shipped to a happy customer. Now let us assume that one doll is missing, or the worker simply forgets to assemble it. You assemble the product and forget about one piece. Do you notice how it takes more and more effort to remove the defect the more value we add to the product? More importantly, we do not even notice the defect once further process steps are conducted. What you end up with is a defective product, which has one missing part, even though you might declare it as flawless. And who's going to notice the defect in the end? Do you have a guess? Yes, it's the customer, who will then be yelling at you, "Why the heck did I get only 3 matryoshkas?" which is your worst case scenario. So one important question to ask oneself is how to detect defects, or even better, how to prevent defects from occurring in the first place. The answer is Poka Yoke. Poka Yoke was introduced by Shigeo Shingo at Toyota in the 1960s to prevent human errors and means mistake proofing. Originally, it was called Baka Yoke, which means fool proofing, but it was later renamed because of this bad connotation. In general, Poka Yoke ensures the right conditions to prevent defects from occurring during the execution of a process. This is not always possible, and in such cases, Poka Yoke at least takes on a detective role to signal the occurrence of a defect or a mistake. Now, there exist three Poka Yoke mechanisms. The contact method, which is based on physical attributes like the product's shape, size, or color. The fixed value method, which is based on the number of movements. And finally, the motion step method, which is based on the sequence of events, like making sure that you follow the correct order of assembly steps when putting different parts together. Let me illustrate each one of the mechanisms with an example. A very classic example is what you see here. The two lower pieces can only be plugged into each other one way. This is a Poka Yoke mechanism that prevents you from plugging them into each other the wrong way, which would actually be possible with the two upper pieces. Another example is, let's say you need to tighten screws. 8 screws. A Poka Yoke mechanism would make sure that you only and always have 8 screws available. It could also count your movements and not let you pass on the product unless all 8 screws have been tightened. And the third example that you probably have seen already in real life is the ATM, that will only give you your money after you have taken out your bank card. This process design prevents you from leaving the ATM without your card. People who are in a hurry might otherwise forget about their card and only take the cash. As a little exercise, ask yourself, have you ever experienced example of Poka Yoke anywhere before? Or maybe you can even think of potential applications in your own everyday life. I hope it has become clear that Poka Yoke is important, but let's recap. It makes mistakes impossible or eliminates them in the process as early as possible. It helps people and processes to work right the first time, and it has potential to significantly improve the quality and reliability of products and processes. Now, if you want to apply Poka Yoke, it's best to follow three questions. What is causing the defect? Is there an easy way to prevent the defect from occurring? And in case of a defect, how can it be detected and controlled? And finally, always remember, if defects occur, do not blame your people, blame the concept. To sum it up, Jidoka is about automatically stopping a process in case of abnormalities, fixing the problem, and solving its root cause. Jidoka is important because it helps to prevent even more issues further downstream, which can eat up a lot of time of your employees or cause the worst case scenario of delivering products of low quality to your customer. Poka Yoke can be any mechanism in a process that helps to avoid defects by either preventing, correcting, or drawing attention to human errors as they occur. That's it. I hope you learned something new and enjoyed the video. Take care and goodbye.